Hello, this is Derek Nastasi with Boots on the Highlands. Today we're doing a different episode. It's actually going to be a Q&A episode. You know, since it's been my fourth year doing the show, Boots on the Highlands, I've accumulated a lot of viewers' questions that people were very curious about, so I'm going to try to answer them in this episode. So, the first question, and this came from a lot of people, who thought of the idea of doing the show? How did or why did it start? So I'm not going to give one person all the credits. I'm not going to give myself all the credit. I'm not going to give someone else. It's kind of, it was a collective almost of individuals. I know I thought that it would be kind of an interesting thing to do, you know, interview people around the school, because I look on the news, especially the local news, because, you know, they're the closest there are to, you know, traditional journalism that we get nowadays. But, you know, they'll do what I like to call boots on the ground reporting, and where they will go to the scene and they'll, you know, ask people questions. So I looked at that and I said, hey, you know, that's something I'd like to see done. And you know, I know someone else, Calissa Jones, she actually came and showed me a video of someone else doing something similar. I forget if that was before or after I thought, but regardless, it was a collective. Why did it start? I mean, it started, you know, because not only I think it would be interesting for that to happen in the school, but I want to give people a voice, kind of a way for them to get their opinions and thoughts out there, you know, give them the platform to speak on certain issues that are, you know, relevant to whatever's going on in the world today, or issues around the school, or whatever it may be. So that's the biggest reason, and, you know, I love the interaction, you know, truly I do. How did it start? Well, it's never been done before at LH Journalism Department, so you know, we, I just kind of started I did the first episode.
We were going to go for Boots on the Highlands, then the fire alarm went off, so this is how LH evacuates the school.
I did not think it would be interesting at all, because, and I was going to do it regardless of what people think, but yeah, I thought it'd be boring, and, you know, people would only watch it if they were, like, really interested in what people had to say, really interested in reporting. It was just going to be kind of more of a serious, you know, what do you think? But it turned into much more than that, and I'm so glad that it did. You know, people come up to me, and they'll say, you know, that's fun. They'll say, that's hilarious, you know, the episode that just happened, so yeah, I'm very grateful for that, truly. So it definitely exceeded my expectations. Second question that I get a lot is, you know, who manages it and who does the work on Boots in the Highlands? Well, it started off to where, you know, of course I'm the host, I ask the questions, but I normally make the questions. There are times where other people will say, hey, you should ask this, and I was like, oh, that's a good idea. At the beginning, Calissa edited all the videos, and I will tell you, the editing is definitely the hardest part. I mean, anybody that does anything with, you know, making videos, being a YouTuber, you know, recording anything can tell you that editing is the hardest part. But you know, she did that at the beginning for a couple episodes, and my friend Max Nasser, he was always a cameraman, mostly. There's a few other people in between there when I couldn't get a hold of him when he wasn't available, that I got to run the camera. But yeah, how it is now, I do all the editing. I do the only person that I work with pretty much is Max, because he holds the camera. You kind of have to have someone holding the camera. This year, it's going to be hard to do that because I don't have a lunch period with him. So I'll have to work something out. I don't know if I'm going to have to sit the camera on the table somewhere or hold it and hold the microphone at the same time. I'll have to work that out. So is there any strategy to who you pick for interviewing? That's one of the biggest questions. That might be the biggest. If it wasn't, I would have actually included that in this video if people wouldn't have asked me. But it's a pain, I'll tell you that, to get people to speak. And I think it's just a generational thing. It's difficult to get people to speak because, you know, I don't mean to, you know, sound like a boomer negative when saying this, but I think we're so invested, we're always on our phones, and that's the main part of, well, that's the main way we communicate. So I think people are so used to texting and you know, not emailing, but calling or Snapchatting, that they're not inclined to speak. And I feel bad, and I'm trying to fix that possibly with this. Maybe that'll inspire other people to, you know, speak in front of a camera, truly. But, okay, so the strategy to behind who I pick. There really isn't a strategy. I mean, I guess the only strategy would be I try to make it a little diverse with the grade levels. So I'll try to get, like, seniors, juniors, freshmen, sophomore, that kind of thing when it comes to diversity. Other than that, I really try to... I'll pick whoever is able to speak, because I guarantee you, you know, 95% of the people that I go up to and say, hey, you know, do you want to answer this question? Because I have to ask around, they'll say no. So it's a tough one. So I end up getting whoever speaks. And you'll see a lot of the same people, which is good, because they're like, I like to hear from them. The audience likes to hear from them. And they have a lot of good things to say. So you end up seeing a lot of the same people. I try to vary it up, but it doesn't always work that way. So how long have you been doing this? So I've been doing this, I believe, ever since, I'm going to say the second half of my sophomore year, because journalism, at least when I was a sophomore, freshman or sophomore, was opened up to sophomores and up. So, and I always said, you know, being a journalist would be interesting. You know, that's one of my career prospects. I actually plan on continuing it outside of Boots in the Highlands and outside of the school. But, the second half of my sophomore year is probably when I started this, because the first half I was still learning the ropes with, you know, video editing and working cameras, actually, because I've never really worked a camera in my life other than my phone. But yeah, that would be how it, when it started. And I kind of caught on, and I said, that's a good idea. Number six, how hard is it to get people to speak? Well, I already answered that. What do you love about the show? A lot. I mean, I really love this. This is, it's kind of my pride and joy, but, no, I mean, I just like that you get a lot of great interaction with the interviewees. I mean, it's amazing. And I'll say at the end of the videos, you know, unfiltered or uncensored, because I don't tell them what to say. I know a lot of times people are like, was it fake? Is it real? I have no control over what they say at all.
If people actually are stupid enough to...
Biggest pet peeves.
Hi, Mom!
The darn liberals, man. Like, they're just stupid. They have no valid points.
The Democrats.
All right. So.
Pretty much what happens, I'll go through the process. I'll say to so-and-so, hey, you know, do you want to... You know, I'm asking a question about, you know, blah, blah, blah. Would you want to answer that? You know, be on YouTube. Obviously, I have to get their permission and everything. And they're like, okay. And they might say, well, let me think of something. So I'll wait maybe a minute so they could gather their thoughts, you know. Or sometimes they'll just jump right into it. And they say what they want to say. And, you know, there we go. Now, at times, I have had to censor some things out, unfortunately. A prominent episode would be the New Year's resolutions. That part.
What? Ah, buddy. Sorry, my family genes are all screwed up.
But I try to include as much as I can. I don't like to just cut out parts that I don't like, because I don't think that that's natural. You know, it's not natural enough. I want everything I can. There are vulgar moments in some of the interviews. So instead of kind of censoring, like bleeping it out, I try to work around it, because I don't want to get that person in trouble, you know, with any faculty members or teachers that watch the episodes. I don't bleep it out. We all curse once in a while, you know, but I will do that, and then the person embarrasses themselves, well, they embarrass themselves, you know. They know what they're going in for. That's with anything, with the news and this. And obviously, if the person says, hey, look, you know, I really, can you please take this down? It's going to hurt my reputation. I'll take it down, you know, edit them out or do something to work around it. I just love the interaction. I love to hear what people say. I love giving people a voice. I like making the questions, saying, man, how will they answer things? All right, I kind of lied on the one question where, what's your strategy of interviewing people? I try to interview people, like, if I know them ahead of time, and I know that they have a very strong opinion on the question, I'll go and I'll interview them, right? But I try to make strong opposing opinions. So, say, a question was, I know, episode one, actually, what's the biggest problem in the world, or in this country? That was you know, if I knew someone that they really, really felt strongly about a certain problem, I'd put the camera on them. And say if they, you know, felt strongly about something else that might contradict the person before them, I'd most certainly put the camera on them. Because it gives different perspectives. And I think that just goes down to the principles of journalism. You want to stay unbiased in who you interview. You want to get all multiple viewpoints and kind of put them together and let your viewers decide. That's really what I try going for there. What do you hope to get out of this? That's a powerful one. So, what I really hope to get out of this is something, you know, fun and enjoyable that students and teachers can watch in LH. And they can be like, hey, that's us. You know, that's our... Yeah, that's LH. We did this. So that's really what I, you know, get out of it. And just, again, going back to giving people a platform for which to speak on, you know, I think that's great. Giving people a voice, you know. I mean, there's people that I ask them a question they feel very strongly about. They may not speak in class, or they may be a little shy. And, to get them to speak, that might open them up a little more, you know, and might change them. I really don't know. But I hope to continue, not me personally, but I hope that the journalism department continues Boots on the Highlands. I have faith that they will. Of course, since I'm a senior, I'm going to be graduating this year. So I'm not going to be able to do the show anymore, unfortunately. But, you know, I have faith that someone else in journalism will come along and will host the show and do a great job. Maybe even by the end of this year they might do their first episode. I really don't know, but I'll be more than willing to help them. So if you have a question about Boots in the Highlands and it didn't get on this video, just leave in the comments section what you'd like to hear answered. Maybe I can answer it in the comments. I will see.